That is the GAT subject management science MCQs. The subject is finance. Number one, MCQs is which group of ratio relate profit to sales and investment? So the answer is, now I'm going to highlight the answer, profitability ratio. You can see that here is the profit to sales and investment. So profitability ratio is the right answer. The dash is defined as the present value of all cash proceed to the investor. So the present value of all cash proceed to the investor in a stock, the answer will be intrinsic value. When the market required of return of a particular bond is much less than its coupon rate, the bond is selling at, so what will be the answer? It is premium bond. Okay, you can note it the answer only, not the other options, because if you focus on other option, you can forget the right option. Okay, focus on the answer only. Now, interest paid earned on only the original principal borrowed lent is often referred to as simple interest. Okay, right? Which of the following is an advantage of corporation? This is not an advantage, it is limited liability. So students, only focus on the answer, not other options. Assume that the interest rate is greater than zero. Which of the following cash flow stream totaling rupees 15,000 would be your preferred? So the cash flow are listed in order for 1 year, year two and year three. So the answer is 700, 500 and 300. You can calculate by yourself. Okay. And the answer will be this. Now dash is responsible for financial inventory management, financial planning. So it will be the treasury. If you have to judge a project from its NPV, you will select the one with the highest NPV. Break-even analysis is also called cost volume profit analysis. Process that involves decision making with respect to investment in fixed asset. It is capital budgeting. The balance sheet, it is before I continue, I can say that this is very important MCQ, as I read this MCQs in the NTS test. So focus on it. The balance sheet amount of total asset is rupees 10 million. Current liabilities rupees 5 million and owner equity are rupees 2 million. What is the long-term debt to equity ratio? It will be the 1.5:1. Okay. You wish to earn a return of 13% on each of two stock, stock X and Y. Stock X is expected to pay a dividend rupees 3. In the upcoming year, while stock Y is expected to pay a dividend of rupees 4, in the upcoming year, the expected growth rate of dividend for both stock is 7%. The intrinsic value of stock X will be less than intrinsic value of Y. Gross profit is rupees 5,000. The net profit is 25 1,000. You can calculate by yourself. The answer will be, don't ever follow my answer. You can calculate by itself. You can calculate by yourself and you can identify the answer, what is right or wrong, by yourself. Which group of ratios measure a firm's ability to meet short-term obligations? It is liquidity ratio. Now, the higher the future FV of the payment, the higher will be its present value. Dash are the analysts who use information concerning current and prospective profitability of firm to assess the firm fair market value. It is fundamental analysis. When a bond yield to maturity is greater than the bond coupon rate, it is selling to a discount. What are the earning per share EPS for a company that earned rupees 100,000 last year in after-tax profit has 200,000 common shares outstanding, rupees 1.2 million in retained earning at the year end. It is 0.50. You can calculate by yourself. If financial leverage means use of more debt capital and increase profit. Life security simple refer to maturity. Okay, thank you for watching my video. You can subscribe my channel and like and share and be prepared for the NTS test. Thank you.